Welcome back to the Ask Professor Dan show. We have an answer to our very first question. Danny, remind us what that question was.
Who serves a specialty food item every Thursday at Spike's?
Erin thinks she knows the answer. Erin?
Could it be Gary's Barbecue?
All right, you are. And for your efforts, a t-shirt just like ours. Right on. Now back to you guys at the studio.
Thank you very much, Danny and Jess. Now it is time to meet tonight's guest lecturer. You see her about every day in the cog when you come in to eat. And when you ask her how she's doing, she always has the same answer. Say hello to Kay Calobeer. Welcome. And so, how you doing, Kay? It's Peachy Kay. The students were so excited to invite you to be tonight's guest lecturer. How did the peachy thing get started?
I was like four, I think, and we had a family friend that came over all the time, and she just all of a sudden started calling me her little Georgia Peach.
The little Georgia Peach.
So then from there on out, I just constantly walked around and I'm peachy.
Yeah. A little controversy when you started working at the cog. They didn't want you to say that.
At first it wasn't an issue, but after a couple weeks it was kind of an issue.
Yeah, but now it's like part of your fiber, so.
Yeah.
All right. I'm glad you're doing peachy tonight. This part of the game is where we're going to test our cyber audiences and see how well they know some pop culture trivia from when you were about the student's age, Kay.
Yeah.
Take a look at that monitor over there. There's some pictures of little cute Kay when you were just graduating high school?
Yeah.
Okay.
And
you went, where'd you go to high school?
Flathead High School in Kalispell, Montana.
Beautiful part of the country. And you were a little bit of a hairband girl back then.
Yes.
All right, so here's what I want you to do, Cyber Network. Take a listen to this song that Kay loved when she was that age. And if you can give me the title and the artist, you'll win a point for your network. Sister Joy, you were first to tap in.
Welcome to the Jungle by the Police.
It is not Police. Oh. Louis, you were number two.
Welcome to the Jungle by Guns N' Roses.
Guns N' Roses. Mm-hmm. I'm surprised Sister doesn't have that on her iPod right now. That is one more point for Louis and the Giving Tree. All right. After high school, Kay did something absolutely nutty. You weren't in the Navy. She went to work on a boat, though, way up in Alaska. There's a couple of pictures of, what kind of fish were you guys after?
Salmon.
That was a salmon boat.
Yeah, they do salmon and they did crab and, yeah.
Yeah, so this is in the 80s, and, of course, she couldn't watch television when she was, working, but every time she got on shore, she said she couldn't miss an episode of her favorite television show. Remember this one? I want you guys to take a look at this clip and want you to name the star and the car of her favorite 80s TV show.
I am warning you, change course at once.
I am not a control car.
Then tell the humans to turn away. This is folly, kids.
He's right.
He's right.
No way.
Michael, what are you doing?
The Brazino and that immovable object thing? About to find out the answer.
Car doesn't have my programming to protect human life.
That's what I'm counting on, buddy.
What? Michael, I...
Do we have an answer from the cyber network yet?
Nothing.
I am incredibly disappointed. Holy mackerel. So what was it?
Knight Rider.
Knight Rider.
The car is Kit.
The car is Kit.
Michael Knight is the guy that drives it.
Ooh, excellent trivia. Played, of course, by Herr David Hasselhoff.
David Hasselhoff.
All right. Boy, yeah, I tell you what, if they didn't get that one, I had some extra great trivia. Let's see if you know the answer to this one.
Snow coming in because I just got
did you get one?
I got three of them.
And the
But they just came in.
Read me your first one, Father, because I don't think you would lie to me.
How many seconds ago?
The first one was Firebird David Hasselhoff.
That is not correct. Did you get one too, sister?
Yeah.
Okay.
David Hasselhoff Kit.
David Hasselhoff and Kit, 1 point for campus. You're on the board, sister. Excellent. So everybody loved that. Everybody was driving those kind of, it was a Trans Am, by the
yes.
way. What did you like about Knight Rider?
Good God, a sassy car.
Sassy car.
Oh man, yeah.
And a sassy star, a little bit too.
That too.
So I did a little research for this. The car's name was Kit, of course, but it's K-I-T-T. Did you know that?
Mm-hmm.
And what does it stand for? Knight Industries 2000. Because in 1985, you know,
yeah.
it was pretty darn hip. All right, so after Alaska. Kay comes back home to Montana and began another aspect of career behind the bar.
Yes.
Got some shots of you and there's a couple of pals you're working with. What kind of bar is that? That looks like my kind of bar. You know, the kind with bottles that they sell.
Oh yes. It was a casino, a small casino and typical bar bands there.
Okay.
Yeah.
But you were kind of an intellectual at the time. You told me that you were a voracious reader at the time. One of her favorite books back then was a really interesting one, Interview with the Vampire by Anne Rice. Well, this is a story of a vampire named Louis who gives his life story, and it's a long one, to a reporter. I want to know from you and the cyber networks, who was the guy who turned Louis into the vampire? An answer from your cyber networks yet?
Not yet.
And they're a little bit slow out there. That's all right. Sister Joy.
Lestat.
It was Lestat.
Okay.
Very nicely done. What got you into Interview with the Vampire? This is way before Twilight.
Oh, yeah. Way before. I thought the thought of vampires were kind of cool. Just a little something different.
Yeah.
And then plus with Anne Rice books, she writes very well.
Yeah.
So it's easy to get into.
So you were the kind, when you find an author you like, you just buy everything she
yeah.
Awesome.
Yeah.
All right.
She's very
excellent.
Good.
Let's see here. Quick score update now. Father Kaysen, Up Till Dawn, has 1 point. Sister Joy with Campus Kitchens, 2. Louis Cunningham and the Giving Tree, commanding 3 points. So you are in the lead right now. Still time for everybody to catch up through the next game, which is the interactive cyber interview. That's coming up next, where you get to submit questions. But first, let's head back out to our live viewing party at the COG with Danny and Jess.
Hello again. We are here outside of Spikes, and it is time for our second trivia question. Danny, lay it on us.
Which COG employee dances every Saturday to the Numa Numa song?
Oh, we have answers. We are watching the Ask Professor Dan Show on GUTV.
I think it's very vital to rock around. That's right, on time.